Welcome to EPG Pathshala. My name is Enreka and I'm from the Department of Food Service Management and Dietetics. Today we are going to see the module on foreign currency exchange. So I think everybody will be knowing about the different types of currencies and you know about how it is exchanged and all. Today we will see on briefly what are the procedures, how this foreign currency exchange is handled. To start with, many hotels having a high proportion of overseas visitors will offer foreign exchange facilities. Hotel exchange the foreign currency for local currency. Hotel cannot sell foreign currency against the settlement of a bill. The change must be given in local currency. Hotel gets the rates of different foreign currency from the bank on a daily basis. Exchange rates of major currencies are to be displayed on a board with the authorization number given to the hotel by Reserve Bank of India. It is important for every cashier to understand the types of different foreign currencies the guest carries. Normally, foreign currency notes or traveler's check are accepted by a hotel but not the coins. So foreign currency exchange and traveler's check exchange is offered to the guest by the hotel. Usually hotels have tie-up with authorized currency exchange dealers like Thomas Cook, etc., for example, and do the exchange on their behalf after procuring license for the same. These dealers send currency exchange rate to the hotel on a daily basis, which is updated on their software and also displayed on the cashier desk. Some hotels provide this facilities only for in-house guests. This can also depend upon the government regulation on that particular region where the hotel is located. Hotel may also charge a commission percentage on top of the normal exchange rate as a fee to the service provided to the guest. Actually, there are different formats for getting the foreign currency exchanged for the customers or the guests who are in resident of the hotel. Say in that currency exchange receipt, you have what all the details of a currency exchange receipt will see now. There will be the name of the foreign currency, number, RBI license, and in the encashment certificate, the serial number, date, and it will be certified that which date the foreign currency has been transacted. Holder's passport number will be given, the nationality of the person will be given, and the paid net amount in rupees after the adjustment amount towards settlement of bills for the goods or supplied or the services rendered as per details will be given below. So the details of foreign currency notes, coins or traveler's checks purchased, etc., will be given along with the amount rate and the rupees equivalent to that particular foreign exchange. So details of adjustment made towards settlement of bills for goods supplied and services rendered will encompass of bill number, date and amount. The net amount paid in rupees will be then given, and the signature of the applicant will be got for authorization. This certificate should be preserved by the holder to facilitate reconversion of the rupees balance, or if any, into foreign currency at the time of departure from India, or for payment passage cost in rupees if necessary. So while handling foreign currency, the cashier should check the current rate, issue a receipt quoting each transaction, guest name, room number, passport number and the rate of exchange. Arrange for the foreign currency to be banked on the following day on a separate pay-in slip, as the exchange rates can change frequently. As a business with courtesy in hotels, hospitality is must with the guests all over the world. So it demands for exchanging foreign currency in hotels, and it's a big issue for the hotel authority to exchange foreign currency in a hotel. So it is noticeable that the hotel can only exchange money for the residential guest, but a hotel has to follow some steps to do the work. So now we will see one by one the step which the hotel should follow in case of exchange of foreign currency. The first work for a hotel authority is to attain a license to exchange foreign currency. Without being authorized to deal with foreign exchange transactions, a hotel can't exchange foreign currency. So, a hotel has to be licensed for the front officer, cashier to deal with the guest in this regard. The second point will be the rate of exchange should be exhibited considerably. Central banks governs the rate and updates it daily basis system. The third point is government monitors all foreign currency that extends by a hotel. For the exchange of foreign currency in hotels, the authority has to maintain some rule that are fixed by the central banks. Now we will see the rules what has been fixed. Firstly, a hotel has to obtain a license from the government to exchange foreign currency. License will be for the personnel, not for the whole member of a hotel or in favor of the specific hotel. Generally, license goes to the front office cashier. Only local currency is exchanged in the favor of the hotel guest. So, the front office should have knowledge about the system before going to exchange for the favor of his guest. The central bank governs the exchange rate. Daily basis updated rate is strictly followed in the exchange desk. So, the cashier can't demand other rate in favor or disfavor his guest. To exchange the money, cashier will ask the guest for his or her identification from passport and will verify the date of issue, place of issue of the passport and its expiry date of the passport will be asked. He will also confirm of the guest status, resident or not. If the guest is resident only, then the front officer will advance for exchanging the money. Next will be for the non-resident guest, the cashier will direct the guest to go to the lobby manager. The lobby manager in turn can give the authorization of exchanging money for the VIPs or for the regular guests. If all things go right, then the cashier will receive the cash in dollars, pound, sterling, euro, yen, etc. or traveler's check. It should be filled out the details in foreign currency encashment certificates. The foreign exchange encashment certificates come in serially numbered book for the better control. The hotel cashier will request the guest to sign the travel check, the same that the guest signed before. The cashier will request the guest to sign the foreign exchange encashment certificate matching to the passport signature. Then the guest will get his or her total money in local currency, what is exchanged by the cashier. The cashier has to affix a copy of the foreign currency encashment certificate to the traveler check. This has to be kept in the record of the exchange. So these are certain steps which the hotel needs to follow in case of any foreign currency exchange. Now we will see how the foreign currency exchange is handled. Reserve Bank of India, under the provisions of FERA 1973, has delegated the authority of handling foreign exchange to State Bank of India and its subsidiaries, public sector banks, private sector banks and foreign banks. They have delegated the authority of handling foreign exchange and they are explained through various chapters of exchange control manual. A book released by Reserve Bank of India, the latest one being the 1993 edition, under the ECM designated authorized dealers of foreign exchange, will be dealing in various foreign currency exchange transactions to compile with all terms and conditions. Again, banks that are authorized to handle foreign currency exchange designated certain branches to handle the foreign exchange transactions depending the necessity and potentiality of branch location, and they are called authorized dealing branches. Besides the above, Reserve Bank of India also authorizes reputed hotels and other private establishments to handle foreign exchange in a limited way. Say they can issue or encash foreign currency traveler's check or foreign currency notes. To cater to the foreign tourist requirements, they are called authorized money changers or AMC. They are classified as full-fledged or restricted money changers. Now we will see on the types of foreign exchange transactions. Authorized dealers can handle two types of transactions like purchase and sale of foreign exchange. When customers tender export bills denominated in foreign currency, the authorized dealer shall purchase the foreign currency bill. When customers request for a remittance in foreign currency towards payment of import bills, the authorized dealers have to sell foreign currencies to him. From this, we understand that both selling and purchasing transactions are from the bank's angle. Settlement of foreign exchange transactions. So the settlements of foreign exchange transactions are made through the following accounts. So there are certain accounts through which the foreign currency is settled. The first one is NOSTRO account, NOSTRO account, or account with you. Example, the account maintained by an authorized dealer with a foreign bank is called NOSTRO account or our account with you. That means NOSTRO means our account with you. When an instrument like a check or an export bill is purchased, the same is sent to the overseas bank, okay, the correspondent, for realization. The amount is collected and credited to authorized dealer's account with them. Similarly, when a draft is issued on a bank's foreign correspondent, it will be paid at the overseas center by debiting the NOSTRO account of the issuing bank. The second account is WOSTRO account. Your account with us. That means your account with us. Example, foreign banks correspondents also maintains accounts with any bank in India in Indian rupees for the purpose of settling their rupee transactions, and these accounts are called WOSTRO accounts, meaning your account with us. The third account is LORO account. Their account with them. This means their account with them. That means, for example, just like State Bank of India maintaining an account with foreign correspondent, say BTC, New York, Canara Bank may also maintain a NOSTRO account with them. When SBI advises BTC, New York for transfer of funds to Canara Bank account with them, Canara Bank account is titled as LORO account. For example, their account with you. When our bank deals in an export credit bill on collection basis on realization of export bills negotiated or purchased or discounted, the foreign currency funds is to be credited to our account. We maintain foreign currency accounts with our various correspondents abroad. The account is called NOSTRO account once the proceeds are credited in our NOSTRO account. We receive the statement based on which the concerned branch who have handled the transaction will be informed. When we would like to make remittance on behalf of our customers towards import payments, miscellaneous remittance, etc., we give instructions to our correspondents to debit our NOSTRO account and effect payment. Sometimes our correspondents maintain WOSTRO accounts, that is rupee accounts of non-resident banks, with our bank, and payment or receipts are made through this account. For exports, they will authorize us to debit their WOSTRO account, and for imports, they will give instructions to credit their account. The account of one bank in the books of the same correspondent where we are maintaining our NOSTRO account, the other bank's account with the correspondent is referred as LORO account. That is, the account maintained by Indian bank with our correspondent bankers, Trust Co. New York, will be referred as LORO account of Indian bank. So now we'll see what are the exchange rates. The rate at which a currency is converted into another currency is called the rate of exchange. Such rates are arrived from the base rate, which is decided by market forces and is quoted on a daily basis. Banks quotes various rates for different types of operations like bill buying, bill selling, etc. The rates are arrived after loading suitable margins as per FEDAI is Foreign Exchange Dealers Association of India as per their guidelines. Now see what is FEDAI. It is an association of all the authorized dealers banks in Indian to liaise with each other with Reserve Bank of India and other agencies. They prescribe the rules and charges for various foreign exchange transactions with the concurrence of all the members. Now we'll see on just a brief outlook on foreign exchange market. Foreign exchange market is an over-the-counter market. It means that there is no fixed marketplace. Market players are differently and distantly located. It has no borders and barriers. All the transactions are put through over telecommunications, followed up by return confirmations. Hence, there is the need of high-level professionalism for the market players which is in place. Market players are authorized dealers, recognized foreign exchange brokers, exporters, importers, Reserve Bank of India. Sometimes market dealers include foreign banks abroad. Foreign exchange market is a three-tier market. Well, the one is merchant market between authorized dealers and the public. The next is interbank market between the authorized dealers in India, including Reserve Bank. The third one is the international market comprising all banks who deal in foreign exchange at select international foreign exchange centers like Singapore, Hong Kong, Tokyo, London, New York, etc. When an authorized dealer is unable to cover a deal in the local market, he will approach the other bankers in the international market for covering his deal. Foreign exchange is a scarce commodity, hence it is subjected to control. It commands a price due to the forces of supply and demand. It has an active market, both domestic and international. Authorized dealers maintain stocks of foreign exchange abroad to meet contingencies in the form of balances in nostro accounts with their correspondent banks. Guest needs for the opportunity to exchange currency and traveler's checks will be carried out to the complete satisfaction of the guest and without loss to the hotel. The procedure is as follows, how you should follow. The first step will be exchange of foreign currency is a courtesy extended to the registered hotel guest only. Local currency will not be accepted in exchange for foreign currency. To complete a foreign currency exchange, verify the currency is one of the hotel exchanges and confirm the effective exchange rate. If a guest requests to exchange a currency is not available, advise them of a location which can meet their needs. Verify the guest name and room number in the computer before completing the foreign exchange voucher or receipt. Record all relevant details of the foreign exchange voucher for the guest to sign. Include the dollar amount and the type of currency received, the current exchange rate, and the amount of local currency provided. Check the calculations for accuracy. Carefully count the currency received from and given to the guest to ensure accuracy of the transaction. Double check that all amounts given to and received from the guest equal to the amounts referenced on the form. Do not finalize the transaction if there is any question of these amounts. While the transaction is in process, the money is on the counter in sight but out of reach of the guest. Until the GSA and the guest are in agreement on the transaction, foreign currency received will be stored in the foreign currency drawer once the transaction is complete. Provide the currency to the guest, counting out the amount so the guest can clearly see the denomination of each and every bill. Advise the guest to retain the foreign exchange receipt for the purpose of exchanging the unused portion at the end of their trip. Complete the transaction with the guest by thanking the guest and asking them if there is anything else you can do for them. So always you should have a pleasing and a courteous questions to the guest. place the appropriate copy of the form in the cash drawer and lock the drawer as needed. So these are some of the procedures which should be handled or which should be kept in mind while handling a foreign currency exchange. To summarize, I would say if a guest's desire is to pay their hotel bill with foreign currency, first follow the above steps, then apply the guest's newly obtained local currency to settle their bill as a cash checkout. The hard copies of all vouchers or receipts should be batched with their corresponding foreign currency attached and should be submitted with the control form in accordance with the end of the shift procedure. So a foreign currency transaction is very, very important, and it is should be handled very critically to have a very good relationship with the hotel and to the customer and for future return of the customers. Thank you.